Rio de Janeiro is one of the most iconic cities on the planet, famous for its breathtaking scenery, laid-back beach culture, and beat of the samba. Rio will play host to the 31st Olympiad. Late last year, Sky Next athletes Glasgow boxing gold medalist David Nyika and rowing world champion Emma Twigg were lucky enough to visit this incredible city and soak it all in. For these Olympic hopefuls, their next goal is to wear the silver fern at Rio 2016. The Barra de Juca neighbourhood, often simply called Barra, will be the heart of the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. Located in the west of the city, it is surrounded by lagoons and mountains and boasts one of the best beaches in Rio. The Barra zone will be home to Barra Olympic Park, the largest concentration of games venues, plus the Rio Centro Exhibition Centre that has four pavilions, the new Olympic golf course and the Pontel venue. Last but not least, the zone will also be home to the Olympic Village, Athletes Park and International Broadcasting Centre.
We're here smack bang in the middle of the Olympic Park in Barra, Rio de Janeiro. And this place is still very much under construction. This is going to be holding 16 of the Olympic events come Rio 2016.
Yeah, it's fantastic to be here and feel that there's actually a tangible buildings around. You know, I can feel that people will be wandering up and down this way. These three buildings to the left are called cariocas, which is a term used to describe the local people in Rio. And a very interesting fact is that the handball stadium, which is in front of us, is actually going to be dismantled and turned into four schools that will be situated around Rio. So a lot of legacy, which is a fantastic thing, and obviously what the Olympics is all about. But pretty exciting to be here and to see these stadiums and picture ourselves potentially walking these paths next year.
I reckon. And also in the background we have the velodrome where hopefully we'll have Sam Webster and Ethan Mitchell competing in the track cycling, which should be very exciting, and I'm sure they've got their hopes set really high.
Can I just say that he looks pretty great in this hat, doesn't he?
Oh, stop it, stop it.
So we're here at the Olympic Aquatic Centre, and obviously things are pretty, well, not pretty near to, but you can get a pretty good grasp on what it's all going to look like.
There's no water in the pool.
No.
In that way.
Small issue. And what's interesting about this venue is that there's a whole lot of little holes you can see in the seating that have been left so that there's ventilation within the arena. So obviously outside it's going to be pretty hot and crucial that everyone is still standing at the end of the day.
Does the temperature affect swimmers?
I think the different pools have different standards. Obviously, they're regulated by their international federations,
yeah.
But I know the Beijing pool was very fast and London again, so it'll be interesting to see how this pool stacks up and how our swimmers like Lauren Boyle end up doing, hopefully coming away with some medals. And
yeah.
This is the future arena where the handball is going to be played at the Rio Olympics. It's got a capacity of 12,000. And the Brazilian women's team have a real top chance at winning gold, so I'd imagine this would be a place that you'd want to come to watch next year.
Yeah, it sounds like it's a pretty big sport in most of Europe, but I think it's going to go off 2016.
Yeah.
So it's 96% complete, so it's just about ready. All there is left to finish is the colour, and you know, in Rio you're going to get it. Did I get it?
So we've just arrived in the Olympic Village, and the vibe I'm getting is very similar actually to Beijing. The apartment blocks are very similar, but they've kind of mixed up the design a little bit. And as we're walking in, we've actually told that sustainability has been a huge part of the construction of the buildings. So they're recycling water, they've got their own power plant stationed inside the village, and they're the first Latin American country to get the tick of approval for sustainability, which is pretty cool. But in general, it looks, you know, fairly well developed and...
Pretty impressive, eh? Nothing like I've ever seen before. From my experience in Glasgow at the Commonwealth Games, this is definitely a big step up. And in fact, there are 31 buildings here which are going to hold 18,000 people. 10,000 of those are going to be athletes, and the other 8,000 are likely to be the staff and the management. So
yeah.
That's pretty impressive. That's a huge bunch.
there's some different things I've also noticed as well. So there's a pool in the actual centre heart of the village rather than being away near the food hall. It's obviously been built with a vision of being sold for real estate afterwards. You've got kids' playgrounds and things around too, which is, it's nice that it's not just solely for the Olympics and that there's some kind of foresight. The village actually is what makes the games, and it's certainly, from my memories of the games, my best memories of being in the village. And you know, you've got your little swipe card to get your drinks and you're just popping them out of the machine.
Yeah, that was one of the coolest things. As a boxer, you fight pretty much every second day, and so tournament can last up to like 12 days, I think. So I found like I was spending pretty much my whole time at the village. Like I didn't want to leave the village every day every second day to go sightsee and stuff, because you kind of focus on keeping your weight up, staying relaxed and stuff.
Yeah.
But so like the village is definitely like what makes the tournament for all the athletes, I guess.
Yeah. The best people watching is in an Olympic village. You know, there's people that are 7 foot, and then there's people that are 2 foot. Or maybe not 2 foot.
I do that in my spare time. I just look at people.
No, I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully touch wood.
Yeah, touching wood.
We'll be wandering through these corridors and enjoying it.
Yeah. And the four goes well with medals.
Yeah.
Hola.
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 Yeah.
What's
para inglés?
We're here in the north of Rio at Deodoro, which is actually a military zone and is host to 11 of the sports at next year's games. We've been to the rugby sevens venue, which is pretty much a sandpit still, and now are at the hockey turf.
Yeah, this place is literally buzzing. There's been 35,000 jobs created, which is awesome for Rio. And even just the backdrop is awesome. I think by the time it's finished, it's going to be a really, really cool place to compete. And I think for the spectators especially, they're going to love it.
Pretty cool what we're seeing around us. You've got the whitewater slalom venue, which is pretty much complete, and then the mountain biking track.
I wonder if anyone's ever ridden over a snake. This will be the place to do it, eh?
I'm sure it'll be bound to happen in some of that forest over there. But this potentially, I guess, is going to be a pretty special place for some of our New Zealand team with Anton Cooper, fellow Nexty, and the mountain bike. But we've certainly got a bird's eye view, and what strikes me is that we're sitting on top of a hill with these amazing venues around us and then surrounded by these favelas.
Yeah.
Where people, you know, are...
That's going to attract some attention, eh?
Certainly two very separate worlds.
Yeah.
Which is, I guess, kind of what we've experienced in different places as well.
Alright, so we're here at the BMX venue, and it's looking pretty sharp at the moment. I've heard it's a pretty risky course.
Yeah, actually someone told me the other day that they've taken out a corner, so maybe that's why it's under wraps.
That's bad. Yeah, it's really bad.
We're hoping that Sarah Walker is going to come and do one better than what she did in London, where she won a silver medal. I was there, it was amazing, the atmosphere was vibrant, lots of DJs, so it's going to be a pretty sweet event, I think.
It's all over in 40 seconds.
I know, crazy.
It's crazy. Sarah Walker actually told me that she never ever does any exercise for any longer than 35, 40 seconds.
That sounds like a dream to me.
I reckon, eh?
Can you imagine this place with the jets on and all the rapids coming down here?
How bubbly does it get?
Yeah, it's pretty wild.
Does it come over the sides? Like,
I think it roughly comes up, you know, just over these blue pontoons are what creates the rapids.
I'm a complete novice. So they put up the flags here, and you've got to swim between them.
Yeah, so they have gates going up, green and red gates, and they've basically got to negotiate themselves around upstream or downstream and negotiate the crazy rapids that get thrown at them as well. It's a pretty cool sport, really cool.
The rowing seems a little bit more PG when you see this, eh?
Oh, totally PG. Totally boring compared to this, man.
Can't say that.
Does this motivate you to be here next year?
It's pretty sweet, eh? It's definitely the kind of place you want to come back to. I think I'd recommend anyone to come here, eh?
yeah, it certainly has created some fire in my belly, and that qualification regatta next year is going to hold a hell of a lot more significance, I think, having seen the potential for the event and all of these facilities. It's awesome.
Yeah, I reckon.